Mallory.
Chris.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
How is weather in Destin, Florida?
Hot.
Yeah, I bet. I bet.
It's been hot, but it is, you know, dog days of summer. It is August.
Yeah, but you're nice. Yeah, at least you have the nice beach to cool off in.
We have the breeze, and the breeze helps. So it's okay.
Not bad. Not bad. Could be worse. So what does your business look like today?
So thanks for having me on. I always appreciate chatting with you or Jamie or both. It's good. A closing this afternoon. Those are always the good days. Closing days are fun days. Another one next week. It's good. I'm doing a good bit with residential, but I have learned that more of my passion is towards those condos. I really do love some condo sales and interacting with families for buying condos. So
the Airbnb friendly condo you posted a lot of?
Yes. Well, especially as I could ask me that again. Sorry.
Well, there was one you posted and I chimed in. I was like, hey, is this Airbnb friendly? Because he seemed like a perfect one.
Yes. So it's especially towards those. Everyone wants to put it either on a rental program or do it where they can, you know, self-manage it. And figuring out the niche for which is best for each family. And they are all, you know, short-term rental friendly. Which one is bringing in the best ROI? I love the analyzation of that. I like the figures. So working with several who are figuring out which one's going to be the right fit, and then watch it make them some money. So that's my favorite. I've learned that's my favorite, but I do love the residential. Today's a residential. It's a great family moving here, military family. So those are awesome too. But they also want to buy a short-term rental as soon as they get down here. So kind of on to the next vacation area sales that kind of are more prominent, I guess.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's what happens when you live on pretty blue water. So
I kind of like it. Yeah.
What? I imagine those type of properties, they move quickly.
They have been, especially with us kind of being a hotspot. You know, we've kind of been the vacation oasis since last summer. And it hasn't slowed down. It's actually just grown bigger. We don't have any vacancy, and people are noting that if they can buy something, whether it's been on a rental program previously or not, and get it on it, they can immediately get some guests in, even starting in the fall here. So, you know, they're jumping on it, and I don't blame them. So,
love it. So, how were you introduced to eXp Realty?
So, Matt Gardner. Famous name, I know. He reached out to me. I was a couple of months away from being able to take the test. It was during COVID shutdown. So he knew come June of 2020, I'd be able to take that test. And he just explained a lot, got on a Zoom and just expounded on it. And then I'm kind of a pretty intense researcher. So I spent some good bit of time comparing notes, and I don't think it can be beat. I'm so grateful. I wouldn't go anywhere else. So
yeah, we talked on an original interview, which that's on my YouTube channel, and it's done very well. That original conversation that I had with you, like, you know, it got a lot of views, a lot of comments. So,
is that the one when I came in from a jog and didn't know I was actually live on a video?
Yes, yes.
I think that was the one, and I was like, oh, I'm being recorded by video. Okay.
Yes, yes.
It was real. It was raw.
And that's all that, hey, that's what people want. But you'd mentioned, like, you did do the research and you were comparing. Yeah. And so in that, like, what were a couple of things that really stood out? It's like, you know, eXp really is the best position for you, the best choice given the alternatives.
So the figures made the most sense. I feel like the cap is incredibly competitive and beats out many to be able to cap 15,000 paid out commissions. The 80-20 split is phenomenal. But even previous to getting into that 80-20 and of course capping and all that, but you've got that mentor program that was the basis of everything. My mentor was phenomenal, and I credit her for so much, because without that, and she was a daily interactor with me for those three transactions, that, I mean, the test is a nice start, but you really don't know much when the test is finished.
No.
And even, you know, I feel like every transaction I'm learning something, and I spoke to a friend that she's done 100 and she's like, I just learned something new I didn't know from this one. So you're always growing, but you got to have a solid foundation, because this is not a arena you need to make mistakes. You're working with money, so you need to kind of be aware and know what you're doing. So I'm grateful for that. I think that's been awesome. The brick and mortar, not having that was a concern for me, and that may be for some other people, but I think I was able to push through that, and knowing you're going to build connections with realtors, whether it's eXp or not, but specifically in the eXp family, I feel like everyone is very aware that, you know, we necessarily don't have a brick and mortar to go to and interact with each other, and they make up for it in the way that you do kind of build a relationship apart from that. So about a week and a half ago, I was kind of boots on the ground for an eXp colleague that was going to be away on a vacation, and I wasn't really needed much, but you know, we're friends and we were able to still look out for each other. Last night, a colleague was able to open a door for me because I couldn't get there as quickly, and she lived in the neighborhood and she's an eXp. You know, so you're not gonna be isolated, I guess, is or you don't have to be if you're just outgoing enough to reach out and get to know them. So
yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've had on multiple occasions like newer agents, eXp agents, reach out, hey, can I do some open houses, or other type of collaboration, because we don't have the physical office. But one thing I like to stress with folks is, like, eXp corporate is in the cloud. eXp agents, we're real people in real communities dealing with real houses and mm-hmm. real clients. Like, all of those are real. There's no cloud about the agent.
Right.
It's just the operations in the cloud. So we don't necessarily have to go to an office, because ultimately when you're at the office in the real estate industry, the brokerage industry, like, that's not where sales happen. The sales happen in houses.
Right.
You're meeting with clients, right. with buyers and right. sellers. Like, that's where the money happens.
Right.
So ultimately now teams have offices. Mm-hmm. Individual agents, like earlier I was talking with Kelly Andell, like, she's building her own office, and so certain agents may want to do that, and that's okay.
Yeah.
And I think Matt shares an office, you know, like your sponsor, with another real estate professional. So
yeah,
how has eXp impacted your business since the point you talked about the mentorship program, which is huge? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Get you through your first three transactions and just really get you on a quick start. But since that point, how has it impacted your business?
You know, it's moral support. It's interacting with people from newbies to the ones that are just doing million-dollar deals. And they're all open to chat. I feel like it is a family. I think that's what's something that's very special about it. I don't feel like anyone's looked down on. I feel like you really have sweet connections to folks. And you know, I feel like I can call on several and getting questions answered. And, you know, I've been grateful to you. You've helped me on a couple of things too. So it's a special group of people. They're all very stellar. And I've not met one that was not. So
that's always nice.
That's been good.
Yeah. All right. What is the, for new agents, because we talked about the, you know, no brick and mortar. You talked about the mentorship program. Is there anything else that new agents should consider? Because ultimately, when you're getting your license, you have no less than like 500 brokers calling you. Sometimes, it's, you know, 15 times a week. But and for the new agent that doesn't know, like, some of them, they already know where they're going to go. But for a lot of them that don't, and they're open, it's confusing, because ultimately you have 500 headhunters and like almost high pressure sales folks like reaching out to you.
Yeah.
What should they consider about eXp that, you know, like, maybe we haven't touched on?
So I think figures, of course, I think those speak for themselves, but you've got the rev share, you've got different ways to build beyond just your specific, maybe even mortar that's competing for your attention, to grow bigger beyond, you know, just your small town or large town place. I feel like this gives you connections across the country that you wouldn't have otherwise, and it allows you to scale faster. And, you know, overall, I just think it's a winner. I don't I'm not going anywhere. So I think it's good. Sales are great. Obviously, that's dependent on how much you hustle. But expecting to double volume from last year, and it's fresh. I just had the 1 year mark about 2 weeks ago. So good things are coming.
And that's awesome. And you very openly said this, that that you've done it as a mom first, agent yeah. second, and you've been able to prioritize your life in that order and still be a successful agent and be a good value of a good agent for your clients, which is impressive. So first year in the books, what was your transaction total over the last 1 month?
So last year was a couple million, right at the cap, but didn't make it. Mm-hmm. And this year,
how many transactions?
12 last year.
12, that's huge. So
some were family, okay.
Transactions are transactions. So a lot like the last 30 seconds here, there was a stat where halfway through this year, all agents, not just new agents, all agents, like 40% of them or so, did not have a single transaction. So you got 12 over the last 12 months. That's a win. That's a huge win. So you'll hit Icon this year, right?
I'm planning on. I got 3 under my belt so far here. So we're getting close for the first 40 days or whatever we got here. So more to come.
All right. Let me know how I can help make that happen. Thank you so much, Mallory.
Yes. All right.
Take care.
Bye, y'all.
Bye.